Good Lord, didn't anybody here subscribe? Thank you.
Alexander is scared, confused, hurt, all because his father is refusing to see him.
You know why I left those instructions.
Yes, I do. It's not the Klingon way, right?
It is a question of honor. And I would ask that you respect my wishes in this matter, Counselor.
All I care about at this moment is a little boy who's terrified he's going to lose his father. Maybe it's time you stopped lying here worrying about your honor and started thinking about someone else, like your son. Would you like us to come back later?
No. Please come in, Doctor.
This is Dr. Toby Russell. She's from the Edelman Neurological Institute. She specializes in spinal injuries like yours. We've discussed a variety of surgical procedures. I'm afraid none of them will repair the spinal cord. But we have found a way for you to regain much of your mobility. We can implant a series of neural transducers into your lower torso and legs. They're designed to pick up the electrical impulses from your brain and stimulate the corresponding muscles. With a little work, you can eventually regain 60 to 70% of your motor control.
The first step would be to fit your legs with motor assist units, like this one. They're a training device. Once you've mastered using them, you can move on to the implants. Now try to move your leg.
That's good for a first try. It will take some time before you get used to manipulating.
No! I will not live like that.
These are very sophisticated devices. With enough time, they will give you
60% of my mobility? No, I will not be seen lurching through corridors like some half Klingon machine. The object of ridicule and disgust.
Perhaps all this seems a bit frightening to you now. I want you to take some time before making a decision. Think about it.
There is one other option I'd like you to consider. It's called genotronic replication. It's still in the experimental stage, but if it works, it will restore virtually all your mobility and without the need for artificial implants.
I thought we had discussed genotronics.
We did.
I also thought we decided against recommending it.
You heard him. He'd rather die than live with the implants. I just gave him a better option than suicide.
He's grasping for straws and you're giving him one. Now, instead of dealing with his paralysis, he's going to be thinking about this miracle cure of yours.
There's a real chance this could work. And if it does, it'll be a major breakthrough in neurogenics that will change a lot of people's lives.
You're using the desperation of an injured man as an excuse to try a procedure that you couldn't do under normal circumstances. I checked with Starfleet Medical. They have turned down your request to test genotronics on humanoids 3 times already.
Are you really going to hide behind the rules of some bureaucracy? Beverly, your patient's life is at stake here.
Look, before you do any of this...
Captain, Dr. Crusher.
Go ahead, Captain.
We've located the survivors from the Denver.
We're ready down here. We have triage teams standing by.
Very well. We'll begin transporting the survivors on board immediately. Bridge out.
Beverly, could you use an extra pair of hands?
Absolutely.
I love beans. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo!